Now let us see how to use the transaction SCC1 to transport the roles between the clients within the same system. Now to transport the roles between the clients within the same system, you can either use the transaction code SCC1 or follow the transport procedure put in place by the basis team. Meaning you could create a transport request, then release it, get the approvals and ask the basis team to move it to the other clients or other systems in the landscape. Or if you want to move the role or if you want to transport the role within the same system, you could use the transaction code SSC1. You should use this method transaction SSC1 in the development system if you have a unit testing client in the development system. Now to use the transaction SSC1, there are two specific criteria. One, you have to create the transport request for the role that you want to transport. And the number two, the transport request that you create should not be released. Now, transporting a role between clients within the same system is a two-step process, like I said. One is you create a change request, that is a transport request for the role in the source client, and then you log into the target client and import the role using the transaction SCC1. Now, only criteria, like I said, in this process is you should not release the transport request, because SCC1 does not work on the released transport requests. So you should be careful in doing this. Once you create the transport request, do not release it if you intend to use the transaction SCC1. Now, the biggest advantage of using SCC1 is that this avoids creating multiple transports if the users get authorization errors during unit testing. So what it means is, let's say you have a client 100 in which the role is created, and you, using SCC1, you transport it to client 200 for unit testing. Now, if you release the transport request and move it to client 200, and while testing in client 200, you get authorization errors, then as per your policy, you would have to make those modifications or correct the errors, authorization errors, in client 100, and then again move it to client 200 for testing. Now, again, you have to create one more transport request and release it. Now, let's say second time after moving, you still get errors. Then you fix the role again in client 100, errors in client 100, and then again move it to client 200. So you do this, you create a transport request in 100, release it, and transport the role in 200 till you fix all the authorization errors. So what happens is, till you fix all the problems, you end up creating multiple transport requests for the same role. Now, if you're transporting the role using SCC1, the criteria is you do not release the transport request. So if you get authorization errors in client 200, you can fix it in client 100 and still use the same transport request to transport the role into client 200 again. And you can continue doing this till you fix all the authorization problems. So in this mechanism, you end up creating and using only one transport request. So that is a big plus advantage in using transaction SCC1 for transporting the role between the clients in the same system. And also, you probably do not need to get approvals to transport the role from client 100 in this kind of, like our example, to client 200. So you probably don't need approvals to do that. But if you are releasing the transport request to move from one system to another system, you will need approvals to do that. So you can avoid the approval process also if you are using SSE 1 within the same system.